We're reading in Titus chapter 2. Please, I want to hear it first. One to be ready. And to be our God. And to whom is the arm of the Lord? Just one thing. I don't read in many verses. I'm sorry. Notice, it is the believing of the report that allows for the arm of the Lord to be revealed. If you are looking for the arm of the Lord to be revealed, then you must believe a certain kind of report. Are we together? Are we together? If you believe the report of the cross, then the arm of the Lord will be revealed in the dimensions that you understand about the cross. If all you believe about the cross is that Jesus died for sin, then that's the key victory that you experience. But that's all that Jesus did. Jesus did not die for sin only on the cross. And he died for many things. We are going to see it. Many things. Not only sin. Now, I tell you, read everything. Who have believed? Now, let's read together. One, two. Who have believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of a dry ground. He has no form nor comeliness. And when we shall see him, there is no peace that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows, and acquainted with grief, and we live as it were our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he abhorred our kind of sorrows. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and his strength. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord had laid on him the iniquity. He was oppressed, and Jesus was oppressed. He was oppressed. He was oppressed. If he was oppressed, that's the past tense. Is that right? Is he still oppressed? When he died, he died. When he was buried, you were buried. When he rose, you were raised up together with him. He was oppressed. That means oppression of believers should be instant. You were oppressed. That means that it's a contradiction. If you are oppressed and you are being oppressed. And he was afflicted. I know that. If you are sitting in your body, that's what you call him. But listen, if you are sitting, if you keep listening to the word, you'll be okay. The word is therapeutic. It has a healing dimension to it. And it does matter. I'm okay. The feelings. Because he was afflicted. Yet, let's read it. He opened up. Is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before shearers dumb, so he opened up his mouth. Aha, let's look at what he was taken from prison and from where's the Jesus? Did he experience it with. Remember the person who claimed this is Isaiah. Isaiah was a Israelite prophet. Isaiah. Not John, just Isaiah. And who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off. Out of the land of the living. For. So there was a purpose for the cutting off. For the of my people was he. Now, whose translation are you talking about? Whose translation? Okay. Read now. And he made his grave with the wicked. And with the rich. Remember that his truth was bought by the rich. Remember that it was Joseph by the one truth. For the virgin truth. And Jesus was conceived from the virgin womb. Is that correct? It's part of the prophecy. It was really prophecy. The rich is dead because he had come over the world. Other religions want domination. They want to rule. But no, his goal is not really to. He rules already from eternity. His goal is to create the so that all that he can. Let's just stop that. Neither was any deceit in his mouth. Verse 10. Aha, read loud now, please. 1, 2. Yet, he pleased the Lord to put me. He had put him to me. When thou shalt make his soul and what an offering. Remember, we have talked about the atonement yesterday. This is what is talking about the world. We're talking about this. Make soul. For sin, he shall